Dear brothers and sisters, most respected Swamiji, I'm very delighted to be here this evening, and let me first of all greet you. Merry Christmas, Merry Christmas to everyone. Most perhaps occasions like this, particularly when I'm out of presentalium, will be remembered. I hear that Christmas celebration has been going on very well in presentalium. Truly in Delhi also, it's going on with equal excellence and in good spirits. Congratulations to everybody. The Christmas carols and the Christmas pageant have very well been displayed. Let all of us give them a good round of applause to children and their teachers. What does Christmas mean to me? What does Christmas mean to everybody? Christmas is not a celebration merely for Christians. Christmas is a global celebration. It is an annual celebration. Based on my experience, I would rather say that Christmas celebration is celebrated in all its solemnity, dignity, prayerfulness, respect, adoration to the highest level only in Prasanthi Nilayam. Only in Prasanthi Nilayam. It's not merely a festival of festivity and gaiety. It is a festival of adoration. It is a festival of longing, yearning, pining for the advent of the Lord Jesus Christ on earth. Jesus Christ's life is known to everybody. Let me relate to certain of the points highlighted by Bhagavan in his discourses on occasion like this. Christ represents what? There are other names like Emmanuel, Yesu, Christ, Jesus, these are all the names. Emmanuel, the Savior from all our bondage, the Savior from all our problems. So it is a celebration of birth of Emmanuel. It is also celebration of Jesus the Redeemer. Redeemer, he redeems us. He takes us towards redemption. Redeem our lives. So Jesus' life is most sacred and has to be cherished by every human being. Bhagavan says that we should live up to the principles of Jesus Christ. For information, since elders are there, I would like to bring to you certain philosophical insights into this Christmas celebration. There are three stages. The first stage is the stage of innocence. Innocence is the quality of a child. The firstborn human being Adam. Adam represents innocence, pristine purity, born with that kind of innocence. Finally, you have Christ on the cross, who is equally innocent. So it is a travel from innocence to innocence. Adam innocent, Christ at the end innocent. In between is Jesus. Jesus represents struggle. Jesus represents hardship. Therefore, my friends, the three stages, Adam, Jesus, and Christ. Adam and Christ are innocent. What is the difference between the innocence of Adam and the innocence of Christ? Innocence of Adam is the one that he is born with. Innocence of Christ is the one that he achieved, is the one that he attained, is the one that he remained. And then innocence of Adam is rather, I would say, unpolluted, unadulterated, is in that state without any struggle, without any attempt, without any effort, whereas Christ attained that state of innocence by struggle, by carrying the cross. Therefore, my friends, let us travel from innocence to innocence, the innocence we are born with and the innocence we achieve. In between is Jesus. Jesus had all kinds of hardships. Jesus faced all the struggle. That's what it is. We are in the stage of Jesus, passing through the struggle, facing all problems, the turbulence of life, the emergence of waves, disturbing waves in our life. So, Adam, Jesus, and Christ. Innocence is divine, ignorance is human. Innocence is spiritual, ignorance is human foolishness. Innocence is spiritual, ignorance is what has got to be condemned. So we should rise from ignorance to innocence, that's what it is. Innocence does not distinguish, differentiate between the rich and the poor, with the class and classlessness, nothing whatsoever. That pure innocence is all purity embodied. So, in these three stages, I will take you to the next phase of Holy Bible. It is Jesus who declared in the beginning, I am the messenger of God. The messenger of God, what do you mean by that? Most of us are messengers of our own selves, are messengers of our bosses, are messengers of political ideologies that we represent. But here is messenger. Jesus is the messenger. Love is God. God is love. Live in love. God is truth. Truth is God. Live in truth. God is bliss. Bliss is God. Live in bliss. So God, bliss, truth, bliss, love, all being one, rolled in the form of Jesus Christ, the Redeemer, the Great, and the Savior of the entire mankind. And the messenger of God, meaning Jesus is a messenger who carries the touch of truth, who carries with him the fire, the flame of wisdom and love. That message of Jesus Christ to everybody. As aspirants, as servants, as seekers, let us begin our life as messengers of God. How can you be a messenger? We have got to receive that message truly in the correct spirit. Soak ourselves, absorb, imbibe, inspire, illumine others with that message. So let's get all that message which is available in the Holy Bible, available in Dhammapada, available in Holy Quran, available in Bible, available in Bhagavad Gita, available in Sathya Sai Speaks. So that message, we should get it and carry this message. It was long time back, it was the decision of Sathya Sai International Organization to spread the message of Sathya Sai Baba. Spread the message of Sathya Sai Baba. By spreading the message, we begin our life as a messenger of God.
with which Jesus started his career. From messenger, Jesus goes to the next level. I am the Son of God. I am the Son of God. Then once you say you are the Son of God, you have right on his property. You have a claim on his grace, and you have got right on his mercy, pardon, benediction, and blessing. So, as a son of God, you inherit all the divine qualities. You go closer and closer, dearer and dearer, nearer and nearer. As a messenger, you are far, just inspired by the message. Coming closer to him, well, you become the son of God. So it is from the knowledge, insular knowledge, you are now in the field of action, Son of God, the service, Karma Yoga. When once you get all the knowledge, all the skill, you are the messenger, make use of the skills in the field of service, then you become Son of God, because God has come down on earth to serve and not to be served. It's for that reason service has been the motto, service has been the clarion call of the most venerable Bhagwan, Sri Sathya Baba. To be very close to Swami, service is a straight airline that will take us to his lotus feet. That's what is most required. We may have a message, we may just carry the message, we may be messengers, but we cannot remain at that stage by just going through all the home science text. Pudding cannot be made. One has to go and make the pudding. By just knowing the menu card, it doesn't mean that your hunger is satiated. You should have the food cooked. Menu card is the messenger stage. And the next stage, delicious food preparation, which is service, Karma Yoga. Therefore, this Karma Yoga is the path that will take you to higher level. Mere knowledge, just gathering of literature, gathering of certain letters, will make you just a computer, a robot, that a DVD or a CD can do much better job. I'm not a CD, I'm not a DVD, I'm not a tape recorder. No, I learn and try to translate into action. Love in action is service. Love by word is just message. Love, love, love. Where is the show me your love? Well, supposing you go and tell your grown-up son, oh sonny, I love you. Dad, how much property you are going to give me? You may tell your daughter, I love you. Yes, would you give me some jewels, Dad? So love must be expressed. The expression of love is what you call service. The second stage, Son of God. Son of God serves God. Where is God to serve him? Where is God? I want to serve him. Where is he? You want to serve him. A simple example. Long back, a student got up and said, Swami, we want to serve you. I want to serve you. You know, Baba said, you don't need to serve me, I have come here to serve you. Right. You don't need to serve me, I have come to serve you. And therefore, serving God actually meaning you are serving your fellow men. Service to man is service to God. And you have to serve him. How do you serve him? How do you serve him? Service is divine. We know the service, the other forms of service in society. What kind of service it is? It is a service just for advertisement. It is service for publicity. Where I serve you, I am superior to you. I give money, since you have money. You don't have money, I have money, therefore I give you. You have no clothes, I give you. Here, the giver has upper hand, while the receiver has a lower hand in the normal sense of service activity elsewhere. But in Karma Yoga, as said by Bhagwan Sri Sathya Baba, Karma Yoga of Swami Vivekananda, the service of the Lord Jesus Christ. What does it mean? I thank you for giving me an opportunity to serve you. You are great because without you, I would not have served anybody. If you do not accept my service, where can I go? Who else can I serve? You have given me opportunity. I thank you. In Karma Yoga, the giver is a lower hand and the receiver has upper hand. That is true service and the spirit of service in Sri Sathya Sai organization. And secondly, usually in the society, service means I am helping you. I am helping you. At least I expect a word of thanks. People say that such a person helped this institution, so and so funded this project, so and so a philanthropist is a reason for the successful launching of this project. It is not so in Karma Yoga. No. I do this for my own sake, not for you. I serve you for my own sake, for my own emancipation, for my own development, for my own progress, for my own advancement, to be near and dear to God. So spiritual service actually meant service is an opportunity. Service is sadhana, spiritual practice. Service is sadhana, meaning we serve with love. We don't simply distribute, we serve with love. Where you see God in receiver, there is God in everyone whom you serve. There is God. So we say Sai Ram and serve food. We say Sai Ram and offer water. I can tell you an instance. At one time, all students have been serving very well. Yes, carrying on brick cement. Suddenly Baba comes to me and asks me, what is it they are doing? Swami, they are doing service. I don't want the service. No, let them do bhajans. Let them do sing the glory of God and serve. In other words, it is true service. If it is done in the name of God, if it is processed by chanting the matchless, glorious name of God, say Sai Ram, say Hari Om, Namo Narayana, praise the Lord and serve. Then only it is service to God. Such service will take you closer to Him and should declare, I am the Son of God. All that you have learned before, the messenger of God, by process of action, by process of refinement, by taking to action, gets into the second stage, Son of God, closer to Him. Then you have all the right. You don't need to pray, Swami, you bless me. Your service will bless you. The spirit of service will bless you. Your honesty, your sincerity, your dedication, your commitment will bring all the blessings. You don't need to ask for it. Then the Son of God goes to the next stage. I'm a messenger. I've got the knowledge. Now I'm the Son. I've been serving Him. I'm seeing Him in everybody I serve. Then I go to the third stage. I and my Father in heaven are one. I and my Father are in heaven. I'm not separate from Jesus. I'm not separate from Krishna. I'm not separate from Rama. Tvamevaham, Tvamevaham, Tvamevaham iti trida. Aham Brahmasmi, I am Atma Brahma. I am the Brahman. That kind of assertion, that kind of experience is possible by serving people. As you serve, you are touching the divine. As you serve the poor, you are closer to the divine. As you hug the person, you are hugging God, God Himself. Therefore, that kind of experience of identity in the process of service will make you realize that you and God are one. He is not separate from you. You are not separate from Him either. That's the reason why Swami always says, I and you are one. I am not separate. When boys say, Swami, You have given us watches, thank you. And I shut up. Would you say, Mummy, I thank you for the nice curry. Mummy, I thank you for the nice chutney. Oh, Dad, I thank you for the nice shirt. Do you do that? No. You have got the right. Dad, I want this dress. Mom, I want this curry. Likewise, you have claim on the grace of Baba. You have got a claim, you have got a right on the blessings of Bhagavan by the process of service. Therefore, I urge and appeal everybody here in the Sai Center of Noida to take up to service as much as possible, because service is the process that cannot be done at a later stage. Therefore, my friends, it is most essential to take service while you are young, while you are young, young in spirit, not young by virtue of age. There are many people who are young with long faces who cannot stand erect, who cannot speak continuously, who cannot work hard for an hour, young 25, 23. At that young age, they are having geriatric or old age problems. There are old people who are younger than the young. They can do the work equal to 3 to 4 youngsters. So young or age or old is not the age factor. The spirit that makes you young. Please understand, my friends. Some people say, I'm retired, I'm old. In this old age, what do I do? Better you go to Mandir. Talk to children. Talk to youngsters. Encourage them. You have money. Yes. Come on, give them to give your money to service projects. Your old age does not stand in the way of charity. Your age, old age does not stand in the way of encouraging others. So service can be done till the last breath. Please remember this, my friends. Till the last breath. You are never helpless. You are never helpless. Come on, you can take it up. Because age is no limitation. What is the age? Bhagavan said, Bhishma was 112 years young. Chief Lieutenant, Major General. And then what about the age of Arjuna? 86, quite young. So it is not the age of 86 or 112. Young in spirit. That alertness, that wakefulness, that awareness, that would make you young. So we become son of God. And then we go to the stage to say, I and you are one, my Lord. You become one with the Lord. I am the Lord. When can you say that? When my heart pulsates. When my heart melts. When my heart reacts. When my heart responds to the woes, cries and the tears of poor and the needy. Then you are God. Then you are God. When once you share the joy of others, when once you share the grief of others, you are God. You cannot celebrate when others are crying. You cannot dance when others are sick. Share, share, share. Sharing is the message of Christmas. Christmas is sharing and caring. Sharing and caring can be transformed into service in our daily lives. Christmas is a joyful occasion. It's a joyful occasion. We don't need to cry. We don't need to put long faces. We don't need to be serious. It's most unfortunate that we made religion so serious. Very unfortunate. That's the reason why youngsters are nowhere in the vicinity, because they don't want to hug this sickness. Seriousness is sickness. Please understand that. Krishna was never serious. Krishna was never serious. You may ask me, how do you know? Have you met him? Well, that's a genuine question. I haven't met him, I have not seen Lord Krishna. But Krishna sang the song celestial Bhagavad Gita on the battlefield. Can you sing in the battlefield? Can you sing if you have a headache? Can you sing if you have temperature? Here is Lord Krishna who could sing there on the battlefield. That is the message of Jesus Christ. That is the message of Lord Krishna. In the midst of the trouble, in the midst of challenges, in the midst of tests, yes, you should be able to sing and dance. Sing and dance. So what is the religion? Religion is music. Religion is dance. Religion is laughter. Religion is smile. That's what religion is. Seriousness, sickness. Seriousness is indication of blood pressure. Seriousness is quite closer and closer to a hospital nearby. That's not that. So let's enjoy religion. Wholeheartedly. My friends, we are already burdened in our life with official commitments, with the domestic problems, with social problems, political problems, with the problems in the neighborhood. Life is already burdened. This religion cannot be extra burden. No. Religion should unburden you. It should not overload you. When you come out of your bhajan, yes, I should see broad smiles on your face. When you sing bhajan, I should see you, wow, you're full of bliss, full of joy, not in your heads, not in your heads. Yes, your toes moving to the correct drum beat of the song. Whereas some sing like that, like statues, whether we doubt whether they're lifeful or lifeless, meaning they do not react, they do not respond. It is not, religion is not for them, certainly not. Look at Swami, when bhajan's going full swing, he's doing that. He's so happy. When he doesn't do that, when he starts reading letters, they're all melancholic, tragic songs. I always tell my students, the success of your music depends upon Swami's posture. If he just enjoys, good. If you ask, come and give your letter, he starts reading. Sometimes letter reversed also, because he doesn't read. Doesn't have to. It only means he gets engaged. Giving you an indication, better you wind up your music program. Similarly, even in respect to speech, when you give a speech in the august presence, divine presence of Bhagavan Baba, when he stares at you continuously and smiles, your talk is interesting. On the other hand, if he closes his eyes and sits like that, he's waiting for the closure of your talk. It only means our life should be full of smiles, full of interest, zeal, enthusiasm, vitality, dynamism. That's what spirituality is. The moment you attend bhajan session, the moment you listen to a spiritual talk, come on! Where is Narayan Seva? Where is the village work? Where is service? I'm ready to come. That is, that readiness, that alertness, that preparedness is what Karma Yoga, the Son of God, should have and should achieve. May Baba bless you with that spirit of commitment, with that spirit of devotion, with that spirit of dedication in service to fellow man. And then, I and my Father in heaven are one. How does it look? How does it look? What it is? Can I be God? God says, I and you are one. It's nice for you to say, Swami. It's not possible for me to accept. I have not experienced. This is what Baba says. It all depends on you. Simple example. When the water is covered by moss, all green stuff, the dirty waters, we have plenty all around. Can you see your image there? No. Clean the water. Remove the moss. You can see your image clearly. Water is nature. Moss is attachment. The one who sees is God, the reflection, yourself. You are the reflection. God is there. Moss is attachment in the pool of life. Therefore, I am not able to see God within myself. I am not able to see God even within Him. It is only because of mass of attachment, worldly desires, worldly commitments. Let us clean up. That's what sadhana is. My friends, people ask, what is sadhana? Yes, what is sadhana? To get up at 5:30 in the morning and sit straight until you get back pain? No use. Some people say, what is sadhana? Take some japamala. Sagam. Is Sachin Tendulkar's cricket score or what? There's a hurry to complete the number. God is not worried about the number. No. Is that sadhana? No. What is sadhana? To clean the dirt of attachment from our mind. To clean the dirt of possessiveness. To clean the dirt of ego. Dirt of malice. The hatred and the greed from our minds is true sadhana. Then you can know, you can affirm, confirm that I and my Father in heaven are one. You and Father in heaven are one. When once that's clean. Supposing I stand in front of the mirror, I am not able to see myself clearly in the mirror. There's a dirt there. Take the cloth, clean it. Wow. You know how handsome you are. Similarly, mirror and the dust. Clean the dust. In the mirror, you will find the reflection of the divine. That's the reason why in the Holy Bible, it is stated, God made man in his own image. But if we behave like images of the demon, who can help us? You are Manava, but you are not Dhanava. You are Nara, but not Vanara. So we should behave as Nara. Naraha, but you are not Vanara. Raha means imperishable. Naraha, imperishable. Nara means not the body, 5 feet, 5'6", 5'4", no. Naraha, the imperishable. Yes, the immortal. You are divine. Body may come and go, but you are divine. That never goes because it is existential reality. To make things simple and easy, my friends, Baba's examples are best examples. I'm really very happy to see all of you listening to the philosophical topic with the depths and insights in rapt attention. God bless you. Usually people want some stories. Usually people want entertainment. I'm happy. Noida wants enlightenment and not entertainment. If I'm you, and you and I are one, why don't I know? Why don't I know? Why don't I experience? These examples Baba has given. What does he say? There's a curtain here. There are children for the choir ready. In the basket, Joseph, Mary, all are ready. There's a curtain there. You are all seated in the front. What should happen now? The curtain should be lifted. Children are already there, dressed up. Jingle bells. They're already there, well dressed up. Perfect makeup. Dance to the tune. They're ready. Our job is to lift the curtain. Similarly, what is the curtain here? The man behind the curtain is God himself. He's hiding himself behind the curtain. What is the curtain? That curtain is ego. That curtain is human mind. That curtain is illusion. That curtain is delusion. That's what Jesus Christ says. Dust thou what? Dust thou returnest. Dust thou what? Dust thou returnest. To consider that you are simply a mortal, that you are perishable, that's all nonsense. It is only curtain ego. When once, oh, ye go, you go. Then you see God already there. You see already there. Therefore, sadhana means egolessness. Sadhana means cleansing of the mind. Sadhana means cleaning the mirror, removing the dust of attachment. That's what sadhana is. Well, how to go about it? Is it so simple? Yes, why not? ₹100 increment will make every one of us to work like a bull for more than 3 hours a day. One promotion is enough to make all of us run like a race horse every day. That immortality, that Vaikuntha, that kingdom of heaven, what? Is not kingdom of Noida, is the kingdom of heaven. To know that kingdom, what is to be done? Where is that kingdom? In the Holy Bible, it is written, kingdom of heaven is within you. Kingdom of heaven is within you. Meaning, all that you want is not outside. All that you want is within you. Happiness you want, it is within you. Bless you want, it is within you. Truth you want, you are the truth. Love you want, you are the love. The treasures are there in the safety locker of human life. But we search for it in the streets. What an awful thing it is. Therefore, sadhana is to turn inward, go to the depth and experience the inward joy, the inward bliss. How is it possible? Swami gives one example. An old lady was searching for something under the street light. A modern boy goes there and asks, Grandma, what is it you are searching for? The old lady said, I lost my pin, I am searching for it. Oh, is that so? Good. Where have you lost? I lost my pin in the hut. Then why are you searching here? Here there is street light, therefore I am searching. Pin is lost at one place, you are in search of the pin elsewhere. Bliss is within you, you want to get it outside. Love is within you, you want to buy it from outside. What fools we are, what fools we are. Baba gives another example. A boy goes to a doctor. Oh doctor, I am bitten by scorpion. Excruciating pain, doctor. Give me some medicine. Doctor said, apply this ointment, you'll be fine. Next day, boy comes to the doctor. Still pain is there, doctor, what shall I do? I say, where have you applied the pain? Ointment? I have applied ointment to the cot on which I slept. Therefore, it is something like that. Forget it. Amrutasya putraha. Srunvantu visve amrutasya putraha. You are the son of immortality. That we have forgotten and we just stood down, applied ointment on the street. That's what we are. Therefore, my friends, true sadhana is to go within. Experience you are the self, that you are divine, that you are eternal, you are not mortal, but you are immortal. That is true sadhana. But we have no time for that sadhana because we are so busy. Baba joked one time, Ariyeva, yem jhanam chestunaru, what meditation you do? Swami, I meditate that my son should have a very good wife as early as possible. Then Baba tells, it is bharya jhano ya, samsara jhano. It is meditation relating to your life. You are meditating on the future daughter-in-law. It is not meditation. And why do you meditate? I meditate that my son should get visa to go to Miami. So it is visa meditation. So visa meditation, job meditation, marriage meditation, office meditation, position meditation, but no time for divine meditation, God meditation. True meditation, what is true meditation? Jesus Christ spent long time in meditation, in contemplation. That is all about. We also meditate. What is the difference between his meditation and my meditation? Buddha meditated. What is the difference between Buddha meditation, my meditation? Their meditation is emptiness. Whereas when I sit for meditation, the whole Chandni Chowk is here. The entire traffic is here. Oh, traffic. But when Buddha meditates, there is no traffic jam. When he meditates, it's all emptiness. It's void. It is abysmal. That emptiness is experienced in true meditation. Some people say, I meditated, God appeared in front of me. I am sorry. You are God. What is it, God appearing in front of you? Nonsense. So no one appears in meditation. Meditation is remembrance. Meditation is awareness. Meditation is to know what you are, not to find. See, that's what Swami explains. In Holy Bible, it is written, seek, you shall find. Seek, you shall find. How does Baba explain? Why should you seek when He's everywhere? Where is God? He's everywhere. Why should you seek? Wherever you go, He is there. So, seek, you shall find. We would say, seek not, He is there. Seek not, He is there. And then it's also in the Bible, it's written, knock, knock, it shall be opened. It's like this. Who closed the door to open? Who closed the door to open? You need not knock. You need not knock. Walk straight, you shall find. You shall find. So knock not, you shall find Him. Seek not, you will see Him. Because He's everywhere. In the beat, in the heartbeat, in the pulsation of the blood circulation, in every thought, in every sentiment, that is divine. This kind of constant remembrance. Baba gives a beautiful word, constant integrated awareness. It is not central intelligence of America. It is constant integrated awareness. Live in constant thought of Him. That is true sadhana. The Jesus Christ the Great. You know what He said? As I read the Holy Bible, as I read Swami's interpretation, Swami, what is this drama? The drama of Sathya Sai Baba is reenactment of old drama as Krishna. Baba's life is tape rewound of Rama's story. Baba's life is Jesus' life itself. What does Baba say? What a beautiful thing He said. It was Jesus who declared openly while moving among the devotees, very close disciples. One disciple said, oh Lord, I love You, I love You. You know what Jesus said? I know. But you will deny Me thrice before the cock crows. You will deny Me thrice before the cock crows. He said, I love You here today. He is Judas Iscariot. Judas. Judas said, I love You. Next early hours, those soldiers asked Him, do you know Jesus? I do not know. Later, you know Jesus? I never met Him. He denied God. But there is one Judas then. Today, every person in the morning is Jesus. In the afternoon, Judas the Great. We all turn to be Judas after betrayers. Anybody who denies God, anybody who betrays God, anybody who will put Him to shame, anybody who will not rise up to His expectations is Judas himself. Therefore, let us not be Judas. But the Judas is better. Having come to know his mistake, you know that? He committed suicide in 24 hours. Because out of repentance. But the modern Judas will make many more Judas, produce more Judas because of electronic computer space age adulteration to the core. So it is not that. It's not multiplication of Judas. It is something like Abraham, something like Elisha. There is one character in the Holy Bible. Elisha prayed and prayed, became prayer himself, became prayer himself. Like that, we think of God in constant integrative awareness, that we feel his divinity from within. This Christmas calls for that, calls for that state of bliss, so as to experience kingdom of heaven within you. What is the heaven? Usually we think heaven is that where people live endlessly. It is not heaven. If you live endlessly, life is boring. Life is boring. A man of 90 years, he can't see, he cannot hear, but he wants to live. What for? He is a burden to himself and burden to others. Life of eternity is not necessary. So it's not that. We say heaven is that where amrut is available. Aha! Amrut, he meant wine. It is available even here now. You don't go to heaven. It is available on the streets. Therefore, the description of heaven in our Puranas is meant for beginners, is meant for poor people, illiterate, to create in them the sense of fear and the love of God, but not take it literally. It's not so. Kingdom of heaven is within you. What is heaven? Manchi cheddalu, manchi cheddalu samamuga bhavinchi jeevinchutuhe bhakti naku. To consider good and bad with equanimity, with composure, is the very heaven in life. Let me take the defeat and victory, failure and success, blame and praise in equal spirit. Yes, you are in the very heaven. You are in the heaven. You don't need to be transported. You don't need to be transported. You don't need any airline to go to heaven. Airline may crash on its way, but the spirit of surrender will certainly make you understand what the taste of love, God's love, is. Not only that, it is Jesus who says to other people who died on the cross simultaneously, you will join me, I will remember you. You will join me, I will remember you. What does Baba say? You may forget me, I will never forget you. You may leave me, I will never leave you. I will never leave you. I will haunt you, I will chase you until I accomplish what I really want to. It is Ramakrishna Paramahamsa who never allowed Vivekananda to waver, who never allowed Vivekananda to run away. Did he beat him? No. Charismatic, divine magnet has drawn him towards his master. Similarly, the divine magnet, Bhagavan himself, will draw all of us closer to him. For some time you may feel, let me have a vacation. Let me not go to Parthi. You may not go to Parthi. Parthi will come to you. Well, I don't feel like seeing Baba. You may not feel like seeing him. He is anxious to see you. He is anxious to see you. He is waiting to see you. He is in you, above you, below you, around you. Therefore, it's not a question of giving up. That's what Jesus said. I shall remember you. You will be with me. So we are with God. And Jesus said, I'm in you. You are in me. Wonderful statements, my friends. And Jesus said, rejoice, be happy, rejoice. Merry Christmas. So all celebrations of festivity should be joyful. What is a festival? Is Christmas the only festival? No, my friends. Every day is a festival. Every moment is a festival. Every day is a celebration. So, a life of joy, a life of ecstasy, a life of laughter, a life of composure, a life of equanimity, samatha sthiti, sthita prajna sthiti, a life of steadfastness, a life of balanced state of mind, is the very heaven what you are, very heaven what you are. Of joy and blessed as you think of God. At this moment, I would rather submit to you the whole of Latin America, complete Mexico, Argentina, Peru, Brazil, Ecuador, El Salvador, Guatemala, full of Catholic Christians, all of them. You know that? Today, 80% of them are Baba's devotees. 80%. Do I say they are converted? There is no conversion in Sai dictionary. Conversion, no. It is only, it is not conversion, it is not diversion of attention, it is only transformation of human heart. It is not conversion, it is reformation of your life. Therefore, many people praise Baba in South America. Many of them have not seen him. Many of them accept him as Jesus Christ. I will also tell you, in Canada, Montreal, there's one lady by the name Miriam, who is spiritual wing convener, Iron Lady. Usually say Iron Man, but I met Iron Lady there. Not an ordinary lady. He sticks to the code of discipline to the core. She made me climb the hill to go to the church. Made me climb the hill to go to the church. I can't say no, because church is here. Christ is there. He may say, fool, why don't you come and see me? So I went there. There, Jesus Christ Lord. On one side, hangers. Many, many hangers. Where they kept the calipers that handicapped people carry, hanging there. All walking sticks are hanging there to the hanger. Miriam tells me, Anil Kumar, handicapped people, physically challenged people, those who cannot walk, take the help of calipers and go over here, hang them here, go back walking normally. Go back normally. That is Jesus the Great. That is Baba the Great. I know one man from Thailand whose body is so stiff, he cannot bend, he cannot sit, quite an young man. He may collapse any moment, but he spends some time in Prasandaliyam. After a month I find him walking normally. Walking normally, that's what I see. That is touch of Christ, touch of Baba, the healing power of Baba and Jesus Christ. Then the devotees tell Christ, O Lord, you have saved me. O Lord, you have blessed me. Do you know what the Lord said? No, I have not healed you. Your faith, your trust only cure you. Your faith, your trust. That's what Baba said in Prasandaliyam. Some people say, Baba is testing me. He has no other job other than to test you. Some people say, one gentleman, very elderly man, you know, and the pet child of Baba. Oh, sir, good. Live in that golden dream. All are pet children of Baba. No, nobody, one is superior to the other. Where are the children? Therefore, we should realize that we are all equal in His sight. One simple example. Brother Bose, the Chaitanya Jyoti Bose father, he sat there, Prasandaliyam during Dasara celebration, Purnahuti time. Swami was giving his message. Suddenly he stopped his message, got down, went close to Brigadier Bose. What happened to him? Heartbeat stopped. That man collapsed. What did Baba do? Bose got up. That is healing touch. The Holy Bible says, Lazarus rose from the dead. Bose rose from the dead. Walter Cowan rose from the dead. Radha Krishna of Kuppam rose from the dead. We also rise from the dead. What do we mean by death? Death is past. Death is past. We don't have to die. All our past is death. The past life that we spent so far, half doubtful, half convinced, half faith, half. You'll never be fully alive. That life of doubt, that life of self-contradiction, that life of controversy is all death. Past is death. Yes, rise up, resurrection. Resurrection meaning the second coming. The second coming of Jesus Christ. Christ rose from the dead on the third day. Yes, he got up. We all get up from the death of the past. We all get up from the past of all failures, of all regrets, of all repentances. We get up. That is true resurrection in life. At this moment, I can also draw your attention. Swami happened to take a person from Mexico to a nearby Bandipur forest, close to Mysore. He was talking to him, "How are you?" Suddenly materialized the cross. You know, this cross is made up of the wood, of the same wood as the original wood on which Jesus Christ was crucified. On which Christ was crucified, original cross. This is the one that Swami revealed to Dr. John Hislop in Mandipur Falls. We are flop. We are not Hislop. When we flop, what kind of experiences we have? Let us flop in His presence. Then we become His flop. Then we have resurrection, the second life once again. What did he say? Christmas is not merely celebration, it is realization. What is cross? Three vertical lines will make you a Vaishnavite. Three parallel lines will make you Saivite. Cross will make a Christian. This way will make a Muslim. But what does Baba say? Cross represents not merely the place on which Jesus was crucified. The central line, I, ego, must be crossed. Oh, ego, go, I can see the Lord myself with open eye. That is the cross. Cross ego, cut off ego. That is the cross that we should always wear. We should come across such a cross so that we get over this ego which is troublesome in every one of us. I can tell you, Jesus Christ, there is statue there in Hillview Stadium. Wow, what a size it is. What a size it is. Jesus Christ, picture there in Purnachandra Auditorium. How beautiful it is. He's surrounded by, you must have seen in the pageant, who recognized Jesus first? Poor people, shepherds recognize him. Then wise men recognize him. The star in the east has told. That is the story. Poor people, blessed are the poor, but they shall inherit the kingdom. Meaning, the poverty of knowledge, the poverty of wisdom, the poverty of emptiness. When once that emptiness comes closer to God, He will be cup of your heart to the brim with the divinity. That's what it is. That's why the shepherds saw Him first. Then come wise men with gifts. They are wise men from different corners. All the wise men are not from same place, from different corners of the world. Who are wise men today? One from east, one from west, one from north, one from south. The whole world comes rolling like a ball to the feet of Bhagavan. That's what wise man represents. Christmas joy. Joy to Christmas. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. And we also find them, the star in the east. The star in the east represents the star that glitters. Star is far above us. We know film stars. But God is divine superstar. There's nobody who is more attractive than God himself. Do you think anybody is more attractive than Krishna? No, superstar. Bhagavan, the star there. He attracts everybody. He is steady there. Come on, look up to me. That's what Shirdi Bhagavan said. I look to you if you look to me. I look to you if you look to me. Satya Sai Baba says, you may not look to me, but I will still look at you. That's what he said. Therefore, my friends, I can go on and on like this because the Christmas gives me joy, thrill, excitement, feel like dancing. Because Christmas is a global celebration. Christmas is an international celebration. Christmas joy, Christmas merriment, Christmas laughter, Christmas songs may be with you forever and ever. I can tell you, most of the parents who are here, we are all blessed today. Jesus Christ has not established Christian mission while he was in his body. Rama service organization while he was in body. Krishna had not established. Their names became popular after left. Paramahamsa's name was popular after he left. Jesus became popular after he was crucified. There's only one who is popular. While alive, while in the physical body, Bhagavan Sri Sathya Sai Baba. And he has given us golden opportunity. Golden opportunity to realize him. A diamond-like service given to us. Serve him in any capacity you can, in any way you can, to any length of time you can. The more you do, more you'll be blessed. More you'll be blessed. So, Sathya Sai organization is gift of Bhagavan Sri Sathya Sai Baba. It is not you that make the organization. It is not that I that run the organization. It is he that runs the organization. Please remember it. It was Krishna who sat in the chariot, asked Arjuna, come on, fight. I am here. Mam Anusmaran, you gestured Bharata, thinking of me, come on, fight. Kuru Karmani, do what I say. Oh, Partha, the son of Pudhi Earth, come on, fight. Oh, Mahabaho, the Vela, come on, do it. I am here. But you do it as Anasuya, without any jealousy. Kuru Nandana, act as he said. Krishna is there, success is Arjuna. Success, credit goes to Arjuna, while Krishna is there behind. Sathya Sai Baba says, my organization is good, my people are good, my people are ideals, you don't get them anywhere. Oh Swami, what is all this drama? We know you are best, therefore we are good. You are the best, therefore we are good. Therefore, my friends, join your hands. Because some people say, well, I can do my own prayers at home. Everyone can do that. That is not enough. This is Kali Yuga. Sanghoi Kalau Shaktihi. Sanghe Kalau Shaktihi. The power in Kali Yuga. Sanghe in community. In community lies the strength. So all of us work together. Encourage each other. Let not be worried about the politics. Some people say, sir, there are organizations, politics, I don't go. There are politics in your office. Resign and come out. There are politics at home. Come on, run away, go to Himalayas. Somebody complained to Swami, Swami, there are so many politics in the organization, what can I do? There are politics in my family, what can I do? Swami said, my situation is also like that. Why, Swami? You know, Lord Shiva lives in the burial ground. Parvati, Kailasa. Lord Shiva, Digambara, naked. Parvati, jewels, latest jewels. Costly silk sarees. Lord Shiva, snakes. Parvati, lion as a chariot. Husband and wife politics. This Baba said, how about two of his sons? One son Ganesha, the other son Subramanya. Ganesha has his face of an elephant. Mother has the lion as a chariot. If the elephant dreams of a lion, it will die. Politics between mother and the son. Father has got snakes around his neck. The second son, Subramanya, has peacock as his chariot. Peacock kills the snakes. Politics between father and the son. But Shiva, is he at least without politics? No. Water there, fire here. Opposite. Therefore, my friends, Shiva family is full of politics about your family. But with all that, Shiva's family is most ideal. Sivoham, Sivoham, Sivoham. I am Shiva. Why? There is unity in diversity. Our sadhana is live together in spite of difference of opinion, in spite of controversies, in spite of heated arguments. The strength lies in unity. Unity is most important here because unity is divinity. Unity is divinity. Why, sir? There is no unity among us. Why? There is no purity there. There is no purity. Therefore, there is no unity. If you say there is no unity, meaning something wrong with you, all the dirt, impurities are there. So, my friends, unity is divinity. Therefore, organization, let's all join together. Let's not have any different opinion, even if we have, take it as family affair. When you have heated argument with your wife, do you run away? Wife has a complaint, as every wife has. If anyone says, I have no complaint against my husband, something fishy there. Something suspicious. When they constantly live together, there is bound to be conflict. There is bound to be argument. Yes, plus and minus. Two wires bring electricity. Contradiction brings the electricity of dynamism. Electricity of power. Root is in the ground. Root is in the ground. Fruit is above. Root in the ground. Fruit above. Root and fruit belong to the same tree of life. Contradiction, go together, go together. Therefore, let's not be mindful of that. Let's take best advantage of the divine gift of Sahaya organization. Let us render service, because service will give you 100% interest every day. It's not annual interest, 10%, 11% bank rates, no. Every day, 100%, every day. That's what it is. Work for yourself. Send your children to Bala Vikas. Let them go there. Let them grow there. Let them know what this country is. Let them know who parents are. Let them know the tradition of this country. As Baba said, a son settled in America comes home after a decade, and father receives him at the airport. A boy, so nice to see you after 3 years. Let's go to the temple and offer prayer to the family deity. The family goes there with his son. he finds Devi Vigraha. This fellow says, "Hi, madam, how are you? How are you, madam?" That is the culture of this country today. If you want Sanatana Dharma to come back to its pristine purity, children Balavikas is very important. I am glad that children today display very interesting programs. It means Balavikas in Noida is strong enough. I am very grateful. And the other day, I was at Faridabad, where Balavikas children sang songs. Open challenge. Elders also cannot sing like that. That is Balavikas. The nascent, the florescent, the radiant, the vibrant, fresh, unpolluted, unadulterated devotion that children have. So join your children in Balavikas. At all youngsters, boys and girls, let them join service activity. When you serve, when the other man smiles, that's more than everything in life. When you help somebody, when that man looks at you with tears in his eyes, well, life is worth living. In the making them shed a tear, wipe a tear in his life, that's the spirit of service. Wipe a tear. That's what Baba said. If we shed one tear today, I'll wipe out hundreds of tears of tomorrow. What is wipe of tear today? The tears that you shed. Ananda Vashpa, the tears of joy, the tears of bliss, singing his glory. He'll wipe out tears of misery tomorrow. So while serving, see the tears in the of those people. Tomorrow, God will wipe out the tears of sorrow on our face. Join that. Service, youngsters will get prospects in their life. You will have that credibility in your office. The boss will say, "You know, Mr. Anil Kumar, he's Seva that boy. He works very well." When there is Reserve Bank Governor signature affixed, it is the currency note. When once such a size Seva done, yes, you have all the credibility, the accountability. All over the world, not only here. And Mahilas, ladies, I want all of you to encourage your children, grown up, to go to service, tiny tots, to go to Balavikas. Baba, bless you and your families, your children. I'm mighty happy to be here. This perhaps is the penultimate session in this great Delhi. I'm mighty happy, in spite of my trips abroad, around 50 countries, my trip to Delhi is unique and very special.
Generally just said, when the clouds thunder, they don't shower. Today I saw something different. Professor Anil Kumarji, you thundered, you showered, and you have drenched them all. I'm so sure that most of Baba's devotees, everybody present over here tonight, is definitely carrying back an inspiration, an aspiration to live those ideals of service, of love, which Baba has given to all of us. I don't need to say any more words, because whatever perhaps Baba had to tell you, he already has delivered it through Professor Anil Kumarji. His association with Baba for a long time, over 45 years, which is almost close to half a century now. I'm sure that fragrance has rubbed on him, and the same fragrance you are carrying back home tonight. I'm extremely thankful that Baba gave me this opportunity of coming over here, being with you, listening to you. And yes, Merry Christmas and wish you all a very happy new year. May Baba's blessings always be with you and your family. Thank you.